Welcome to the world of Beanie Babies. I'm Danielle.
And I'm Sam. This program is for beanie enthusiasts of all ages, and there certainly are a lot of you out there.
It's estimated that close to 10 million people collect Beanie Babies. For many of us Beanie Kids, we just love them because they're so cute and cuddly, and you can squish them and toss them and stack them up and dress them up and... Sorry.
For others, collecting beanies is an obsession.
Like you beanie moms out there.
There are over 185 different types of beanies. But if you add the beanies that have been featured in promotions at sporting events, Broadway theaters, etc., etc., some people say there are well over 200 different beanies.
We went out and asked people just why they're so crazy about these beanie babies.
Because they're so adorable. I mean, you can't beat a beanie baby. They're just so harmless and cute, so. And they're fun.
You can just play games with them, toss them around and stuff.
I don't know.
It's just something to collect.
They're so cute and like something to hold or something. And they keep you like company in a way, you know?
They're directed towards any age. Like, you don't have to be like under 5 to have them. They're something that everyone loves.
They're cute. They don't move.
They're fun to play with and they're fun to look at. You may have it for a long time, maybe a lot of money, next few years. That's why they collect them.
I started buying a few for my grandkids because I thought they were so cute. And then I got hooked. That's it. I just have to have them.
Yeah. One of the ladies at the bowling alley in Michigan, we were bowling, told me that there was a new hot item out. And I just started going to the stores and looking for them. And became obsessed with it.
Once you start, you know, picking up a couple, it's like all of a sudden you need the other ones that you don't have.
Started to just pick, you know, bears, dogs, cats, that kind of thing. And now I got hooked, so, just because they're so cute.
Because, they just are, I guess.
Well, it's pretty obvious that everyone loves beanies.
You said it. Now, throughout the program, we're going to be giving you a beanie quiz. When you see these graphics, you'll know it's time for a beanie quiz.
Pretty impressive graphics, Danielle.
Thank you. Now, here's your first beanie quiz. What makes a beanie a beanie? Beanies are filled with PVC pellets, or beans, and when the creator of Beanie Babies, Ty Warner, designed them, he purposely left them underfilled, which makes them so, well, squishy, which makes them so cuddly.
As Danielle just told you, Beanie Babies were introduced in 1993 by Ty Warner, who appropriately named his company Ty. So it's not a real Beanie Baby unless it has the Ty logo on it, both on the swing tag and the tush tag, but more about that later.
Ty started out with 9 original beanies, releasing copies of his larger stuffed animals. Can you name the 9 original beanies?
The answer is Spot, Patty, Chocolate, Cubby, Flash, Legs, Pinchers, Splash, and Squealer.
Oh, Beanie Babies had their debut in stores in 1994, and as the collection grew, so did their popularity. By 1996, beanies were so in demand that Ty had to lease 3 airplanes to fly an emergency shipment of beanies in time for Easter.
Once they arrived, it was pandemonium.
7, 8, 9, 10, 11. We're mothers.
You get caught up in this madness and you call and then you go stand in line and you do this.
Some beanie moms will go to any lengths.
I said, I'm really sorry, there's only 3 per family. And she looked at me and she said, that's not my son. And he said, but mommy, I am your son. And she goes, no, you're not.
In 1996, Windsor's Flowers in Memphis started selling Beanie Babies and saw a definite difference in their customers.
We can be up front looking outside in the parking lot and see some women walking up, men walking up, and I can tell you if they want flowers or Beanie Babies. There's a different look. You can tell they're on a mission. It's serious. And when they walk in the door, can I help you? Yeah, I know what I'm looking for. They go straight to the beanie rack behind me, and if it's not what they want, there's a few questions. And when are you gonna get them? And when are you gonna get them? And how soon are you gonna get them? And if we don't have them, they're gone, they leave.
Now it's time for your first fun beanie fact. Everyone knows that a beanie is more valuable with the Tang tag still on. Or as it's known to us beanie purists, it's swing tag. Did you know that there are 5 different types or generations of swing tags? There are also different types of tush tags. These tags are actually sewn onto the beanies themselves. We spoke to Jonathan Levy, known to everyone as the Beanie Boy, and owner of the Beanie Outlet, about the different types of swing tags.
There's generations. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 generations at this point, and generations meaning that 1993 would have been a first generation tag, a single tag with only a to from or a style number on the back. It was a black and white tush tag dated 1993. Generation 2, the tag opened and closed with a to from, I love you kind of thing to give to kids or give to a loved one if you were giving it away as a gift. Third generation, the tag also to from, the big fat no star on the hang tag here. That's important to have those big fat letters. Inside you want to have this big bold print and you want to have that clean to from side as well as the barcodes and your beanie's authentic style number on the bottom of the tag here. This is a fourth generation Quackers tag. Quackers, now it has no to from on the inside, but it does have the same style numbers and the barcode on the rear. And in the word original, the printing is bold and clean, whereas in the new hang tags, which would be a fifth generation tag. If you could get in real close, you can see that the word original here has a hieroglyphic to it. It's a little bit of a script as opposed to that flush, blunt, bold tag. Inside again, still the same. Without the to from, your normal tag, and again, your style number on the back here.
Besides the first generation tush tags, there are second generation tags, which have the tie logo but no beanie name, third generation tags that include the beanie name, fourth generation tags that have a sticker placed on the tag that adds a star to the tie logo, and fifth and sixth generation tags that have the tie with a star printed right on the tag. The importance of learning about tags is that you can easily identify the age of a beanie by the age of its tags.
This cranberry bear. Cranberry is a second generation with a black and white tush, 1993, made in China, not Korea. And on these tags, you would only have a barcode. On the inside of the hang, you would have the to from tag, to from being if it was going to be for a gift. And preferably it wouldn't have a crease as this one does. But this bear in itself is one of the hardest colored bears, cranberry, to find on the market today.
Beanies come in all different types, but the most popular of all are the bears. There are currently 31 bears in the Beanie Baby collection, ranging from the very first, Cubby, to the most recent, Glory. When first released, Beanie Baby bears had different faces than the current bears. These are called Old Face Teddies. Their eyes were wider apart and their faces were less rigid. Not many of these bears were produced, making them very valuable.
Many people who are just casual collectors only collect one type of beanie, such as cats, dogs, bears, etc. It's an easier way to start a collection, and if the fad ever dies out...
Which we all know will never happen.
Absolutely. You still have a collection of the animals you like. You can collect just farm animals, dogs, cats, wild animals, birds, creatures that live above the sea, creatures that live below the sea, bears, of course, rabbits, and some animals that don't fit any category. They're just cute. We asked people what their favorite Beanie Babies are and why.
Goldie. I love frogs, so the frog.
I'm probably Dobie and Erin.
Erin, because it's the newest.
Okay. I like the,
that Valentine bear.
My favorite beanie is probably Garcia. I like just the plain teddy.
Well, I like Peanuts because he's my favorite color and I think elephants are really cute.
I like Scotty because my dog is Scotty and I think he's really cute.
My favorite is Seymour.
Mine's Seaweed.
What animal is the favorite of Ty Warner, the creator of Beanie Babies? The answer is cats. Okay, let's review what we've learned. Official Beanie Babies are made by Ty Incorporated, were originally released in 1993. There are over 200 different kinds. They're filled with beans made of PVC pellets. The original nine are Spot, Patty, Chocolate, Cubby, Flash, Legs, Pinchers, Splash, and Squealer. There are 5 different swing tags, 8 different tush tags. There are zoo animals, farm animals, cats, dogs, bears, and they are very, very, very cute.
Well done.
Thank you. I'll be over there.
What makes beanies so much fun is that they have become collectibles, meaning people collect them. And the number of Beanie Baby collectors grew rapidly because most of the beanies in their original collection were easy to find and affordable, around $5. Before they knew it, many people had 20 beanies, then 30 beanies, and then 50 beanies. And then, well, you get the picture. Once Beanie Fever hits, people go searching to add beanies to their collection that they can't easily find.
Generally, when they get in now, they get in very quick. They want to buy like 100 pieces right off the bat. Make sure they get all of them right away. It's almost to catch up to the other people. It's also easier to get the regular pieces now than it was previously. So you could run around to 100 places and get one of each of the ones you don't have.
No, I think I jumped from 10 to like 200 because I just got so tired of the kids. Mom, I want this one, I want this one. And so I just said, forget it. I'm buying every single one I can, and I'm going to buy duplicates of them too, because I'm not going to hear, you know, I have to run out for this birthday present and they want this Beanie Baby right away and everything. So we just kept buying the extras and extras. So before I started looking at what I'm really going to do with them, we must have had probably about 200 to 300 of mm-hmm. them, I bet. Yeah, quite a few of them.
We would really like to have Glory, but we don't know if we're going to spend $75 for him or not.
Since there are more people collecting than there are beanies, it makes it more difficult for every person to get every beanie. And so the price people will pay for a beanie they must have goes up. It's a simple case of supply and demand.
When Aaron first came out, you know, there was all kinds of mystique and hype as to whether Aaron would continue or whether Aaron was just being put out for St. Patrick's Day and being retired. And my mother was getting ready to have her birthday, and my mother had decided she liked Beanie Babies, and that's another story. And so for her birthday, what can you get your mother? I mean, your mother has pretty much everything that she wants. So I got her some Beanie Babies. I got her a princess and an Aaron. And so the Aaron that I got back in March was very expensive. The Aaron that I bought 3 weeks ago was not. Same bear. But in order to get her in March, I had to pay a lot more money.
I saw all of these colored teddy bears. They were just great. But I was picking out the little animals for my grandkids, so I didn't buy them.
Because they weren't that cute.
No, I just had to have the animals. So then we have, they're real valuable.
And we missed those. Yeah.
And so I don't have them, and I am so mad I didn't buy them. That's why I think I'm going to have to buy Glory. Fork over $75 for Glory.
What a deal.
You think that's a real deal?
Mm-hmm.
You know, at the All-Star.
Yesterday it was $100.
What is the most valuable Beanie Baby? Although there are rarer Beanie Babies, Peanuts the Royal Blue Elephant is generally considered the most valuable Beanie Baby.
One of the rarest Beanie Babies was a new face Violet Teddy, given out to Thai employees for Christmas in 1997. With only 300 to 400 ever made, it's said to be worth around $4,000. If I had one now, I could be lounging on the French Riviera. Au revoir, mon chéri, au revoir.
I've always liked the bears. I thought the bears were really cute. I knew that it was a very limited supply of these bears, and I just decided I had to have them. And here they are.
Earth to Sam. Come in, Sam. Oh. Welcome back.
Sorry. So, we've learned that the amount manufactured of a particular Beanie Baby will affect the value of that beanie. But what else affects value?
Age is a factor. The older Beanie Babies are harder to find because in 1994 and 1995, many people weren't collecting Beanie Babies. Yet some beanies introduced in 1993 and 1994 are still easy to get, like Chocolate the Moose. Why? Because Ty is still making them. So a more important factor is whether the Beanie Baby is retired. There are currently 119 retired Beanie Babies. Combine that with the age of the beanie and you've got a potential winner.
Mistakes happen, but when they happen to a Beanie Baby, it makes a very valuable mistake. A common mistake is a misspelled swing tag. Don't get too excited if you have one of these. It doesn't add too much to the value of your beanie. But some beanies are mistagged, or mistakes happen in manufacturing, which makes that beanie different. To the average beanie fan, these mistakes are simply mistakes. To a collector, they're worth money.
This is Inky. He is the most recent of the retireds of Inkies. He should have the 8 legs. Some of them come with 9. As you can see, here's a pink one without a mouth. But a lot of people say that it doesn't matter because a lot of people pull this out. But I traded a little girl for it, so I know she didn't do it and everything. But so that's why I keep him. I sort of like him. And this is the tan Inky, which is one of the older ones with the mouth. These all are the stripes. This is the recent retired stripes, and he's a lot wider in his stripes. The old stripes, which is one of my favorites because he's so different looking and older looking, is more of a orangey color with the stripes a lot closer together. I never knew the difference between the fuzzy belly and the regular belly, but it's really quite noticeable. If you hold them up so you can see their bellies, the one on my right is the fuzzy belly. This one here is the spot with no spot. I get a lot of people that always ask me, well, where does he have the spot? And it's always back here. He'll always have it over his eye, as you can see, but on his back, he won't have the spot on him. And he's a cute one. He is one of the very first original ones. Here, this is a blizzard with no tail.
Derby, I happened to walk into a store, just a regular retailer, and I was looking through the beanies one day, and I found him, and he's uncut, and I brought him home. And is he worth more than a Derby that's cut? Maybe, because he's different, he's an oddity. But since I'm not going to sell him, what's he worth? He's worth the $5.99 I paid for him.
Another factor is the condition of the Beanie Baby. Here's a good rule of thumb to determine the resale value. Find out the average price people will pay for a mint condition beanie. Then subtract 40% of that price if you have a creased swing tag, 50 if you have a missing swing tag, and 75% if there's a missing tush tag. If you've written your or your child's name on the tag, it's also lower in value. If it's worn, dirty, or been washed, that also reduces the value. If you have a combination of any of these, well, shoulda, coulda, woulda, at least you still have a very cute Beanie Baby.
Did you know that there's a Beanie Baby in the Baseball Hall of Fame? On May 17, 1998, Valentino was given out at Yankee Stadium as a promotion, the same day David Wells of the New York Yankees pitched a perfect game.
Sporting events are a fun way to collect Beanie Babies. Many basketball, baseball, and even football teams are giving away Beanie Babies as an incentive to the fans to come to the ball game. Many of these beanies have become very valuable. In Chicago, they gave away Cubby the Bear on opening day, guaranteeing a sellout. It included a special commemorative card that proves this beanie was a part of the special promotion. This glory was given away at the 1998 All-Star Game in Colorado and is in very hot demand.
When the Oakland A's gave away Peanut the Elephant, their attendance skyrocketed. It was so popular, they announced a second Beanie Baby giveaway. Their own elephant mascot, Stomper, was so excited, he dressed up as a real-life peanut. Jamie Golden has become one of the premier collectors of Beanie Baby sports memorabilia.
I think the first specialty beanie I got was the Baldy. And he was from the Philadelphia game, and both my daughter and I went to school in Philadelphia. And when I heard that they were going to have a beanie giveaway up there, I tried to see if we knew anybody who was going, and we didn't. Then I called the newspaper to see if I could find someone who was advertising that they had one for sale, and I couldn't find anything. So I went to the internet and found Baldy on auction. And he was expensive, but I decided I wanted him. So we got them.
We asked Jamie how she kept her collection so current.
Well, if I'm lucky enough to have a friend going to a game, I'll ask them to pick up two or three of the beanies for me with the cards and hopefully the ticket stubs now. That didn't used to be so important, but it is now. And so what I will do is, you know, pay for those beanies. And then when somebody else around the country, and I now have a little network of people who also do the same kind of thing, you'll email them and say, hi, I've got such and such. Do you have anything you'd like to trade for this? So you trade with people in Ohio and California and, you know, interesting people you meet this way.
So you've decided to become a serious collector. Let's meet some collectors and find out how they did it and why.
Hi, I'm Laura Sanifer, and welcome to my beanie room. The very, very first beanie I ever got was Sly the Fox. I now have 155. I just really liked him a lot. So I was gonna ask my grandma if we could start collecting them. She said, sure. And we just went on from there.
Lauren keeps her special beanies in protective cases all around her room. In less than 1 year, she's collected many of the most valuable beanies, including Orange Digger, Chops, Peking, Chili, Bumble, Tank, and many of the colored teddies. But she's had a little help.
I think we saw them in Hallmark stores.
No.
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 Where were we?
We were at Shooby-Doo.
Shooby-Doo, the children's shoe store here. Okay. And I got Sly for Laura and Bones for Jason, my little grandson. And then it just continued from there. They're such a nice gift for other children. They're lovable. I love them myself. I'd like to have a collection myself if I didn't have to be supporting hers. So people are telling me, oh, you're going to put your granddaughter through college with this. I'm not counting on that because it could change tomorrow. But it continues to have momentum, so who knows? However, I've not probably been a really smart collector. I've probably paid more than I should in a lot of times. But I still think, as a collector, I think it'll go. I think it'll last now. It's been going on a long time.
I realize I crossed the imaginary line when my husband wouldn't go down to our family room in the basement anymore because of all the beanie babies around. And so that's when we started trading in all of the extra currents that we had for some of the older retired ones and built our way up from there.
Collector Brenda Sessa added the beanies she wanted for her collection by trading with dealers and other collectors.
You have to have something that someone wants. Like for the trap that we got, the old ones weren't selling at the time, but the current ones were. So the dealers were willing to take all your extras that you had and trade you for them, which would bring you down in price for them.
He's an old one, and he's my favorite because he can just sit in your hand, and he's not a real big one that just flops down, and you can, like, carry him around with you, like, in your backpack if he wasn't worth so much. And I just like, everybody would think he'd be ugly, but he's not. He's a cute little rat.
For Brenda, there are two different strategies you can follow.
Well, you either have to have the new ones right away, because then people will pay you more or trade you more for it. Either way, you come out ahead, being one of the first to have something. Or what you need to do is get lucky. Which ones are going to retire? There's going to be retirement coming up the end of September, October. So Which ones do you think are going to retire? What's the rumor? Talk, go to the web chat rooms, visit the internet, see what people are doing, go to the different beanie shows and see what the dealers are going for, because everything goes in a wave. If it doesn't, even if you guess wrong, then just hold on to it. Don't get anxious and sell them right away or just get rid of them. Hold on to them, because pretty soon that one will be a hard to find one and it'll come back. It all goes around in a circle. So you just have to have a lot of patience and money. Money to have all the old ones.
Every collector has their prize jewel, and the Sessas are no exception.
Well, he's the royal blue peanut, and there's very few of them that were produced. I think he's pretty. A lot of people say they think he's ugly, but I think he's really pretty with the dark blue color and then the pink ears. That's the only other color on him, is the pink ears and everything. His color, like you stated, is the color of Kiwi's beak. I don't know where Kiwi is. He jumped really, really high in price. He wasn't that... when I first started out, if I would have had enough foresight, he wasn't that expensive then. I think they were going for like $200 at the time and everything. But now he's just taken off, and he's over $5,000 now for a mint royal blue peanut and stuff. I think he's pretty.
I have probably 168 beanies. I still do not have a full set. It's very hard to get a brownie. And it's very hard to get a punchers with tags. I've had offers, and I can buy them. But for me to spend $65,000 on those last 20 pieces, I don't know how quick I would be to do that. I have a full fourth generation, third generation set. And I enjoy my first and second generation pieces, but I don't consider that part of a set. I would tell people to start with the bears. The bears are all expensive, yes, but the best thing to collect, because people always collect bears. Then break yourself down into generations, from fifth generation to fourth generation to third generation, and then start worrying about, it's going to start to cost you in the thousands of dollars to get into that second and first generation. But don't say, because I don't have the first and second generation, I don't have a collection. That's not true. You can collect just the third generation and become a third generation collector and have a collection that's got a very, very substantial value. Whereas other people come in and they go, I bought this one and that one and I don't like that one, so I'm not going to buy it. If you don't stick with a fifth, fourth, third, second, first generation type of collection, you will not have beans.
Once you've decided to become a collector, where do you get those beanies you've always dreamed of?
The first place to look is your local small retailer. Because Thai only sells to small retailers and not to large toy distributors, beanies are harder to find, which drives up the frenzy to find them. But if you play it smart, you just might find that hard-to-get beanie at the suggested retail price of $5.99, a real beanie bargain. One suggestion is to call ahead to your local stores to find out when they will be getting a new shipment of beanies. They usually come in once a month.
If you have no patience to wait for your local store to get them in, there are other places to get beanies. One place is at Beanie Baby shows, which are cropping up all over the country. Beanie shows are where secondary market sellers and beanie collectors meet. Secondary market sellers are people who sell collectibles, like Beanie Babies, outside of the retail store to collectors who are willing to pay more for the collectible they want. In this case, hard to find Beanie Babies. But beware, the prices here can be quite steep. It's a great place to find that one or two beanies you've always wanted to have in your collection.
I got Goldie and Velvet and Speedy. Thank goodness I've got this.
These shows can also be a great place to find unusual items for your collection, like these miniature beanbag chairs for your beanie, or the Swarovski crystal crown for your princess bear. After all, a princess deserves the best, doesn't she?
Our own Beanie Boy was at this particular show, selling his hard-to-find beanies.
This is the one with the felt antennas.
Okay.
So, real rare, hard to find. Still got a fourth-generation hang tag. Nothing amazing.
What about this one?
Which one's that? Oh, that's Webb, second-generation hang tag. little crease, but giving them away at half price is worth $1,800. Sell it for $750.
A better place to find the next great beanie for your collection is at a secondary market store, like the Beanie Outlet, where you can pick up older beanies at reasonable prices. Plus, pick up that one great one that you just gotta have in a much more relaxed atmosphere.
What a deal. What a bargain I got today.
Yeah.
Plus, these outlets do the legwork for you to get those really rare ones.
Are different. We are here for the collector. We are here for the person that can go in and buy this from Mary's Homework, but then when they need a piece like a princess. Very hard to find. When it's not hard to find, it's one of those pieces that they get 36 in a Thai dealer store, and I buy these by the hundreds of dozens at a time from stores that no longer want to sell beanies, from brokers. They're just out there to be had, and I can get it for the collector. When it comes to a Royal Blue Peanut, you want quality. You want the best Royal Blue you can find. You don't want a third generation, which could be a Royal Blue Peanut that never had a tag. It was torn off from when it was first purchased and replaced with a third generation peanut tag, light blue, which makes that third generation Royal Blue Peanut not as valuable as a first or second. So we at the Beanie Outlet, you know, through the internet, through the help of brokers around the country, will find you any beanie as if you were finding a collector car.
Another beanie outlet we visited was the Beanie Cave in Long Island, New York. Here, beanies are on display in a museum-like setting, making it fun for kids to visit and easy for the serious beanie shopper to get away from the crowds to buy the beanie of their dreams. Finally, the best source of beanies and beanie information is the internet. Type out Beanie Babies on your search engine and you'll probably get a list of 1,000 sites with lots of useful information and services. You can buy and sell individual beanies, make trades, or even make a deal to get the entire collection. There are classified ads, message boards, price guides, chat rooms, even beanie auctions.
Most of the beanies I found are on auction. You know, they're going up on auction, and it can be more expensive that way, but if you're a collector and you have to have a certain beanie, you can usually find them on auction. As far as trading, once I started meeting people through buying beanies, I would say to them, well, do you have anything else? So once you've bought from them, then you'd say, you know, I'm looking for such and such, and they'll say, well, I don't have it now, but I'm going to the game, or, you know, something of that nature.
Well, you have to find a site that you feel comfortable with, either if there's auction sites or different beanie sites. A lot of people start off on the Thai site. And my favorite is either the Beanie Mom or Kim and Kevin's Collectibles, or they have new member to member on America Online in their classified ads, or there's certain cities you go to, like to get my special or my All-Star Glory right after this game. I went into the Denver classifieds there and looked around and seen what people were selling there. So you just find a site that you're comfortable with.
The best part about checking out what's available on the internet is that you'll get the best sense of how much people are spending on individual beanies. So when you go to a beanie show or a specialty store, you'll know that the price you'll pay for your beanie is fair. One important note to you kids: never give your name, address, or telephone number to anyone over the internet. If you're interested in buying, selling, or trading your Beanie Babies online, ask your parents for help first.
Rock Island is a tiny island off the coast of Rhode Island. During the winter months, only 875 people live there, making it quite possibly the only place in the United States where there are more beanies than people. Over the past few years, the world of Beanie Babies has really become the world of Beanie Babies. On July 1st, 1996, Thai introduced Maple Bear with a Canadian maple leaf. And in 1997, Thai introduced Britannia Bear with the English Union Jack.
Not to be outdone, Thai also produced the American Trio: Lefty, the Democratic Donkey; Righty, the Republican Elephant; and Liberty, the All-American Bear. These special beanies all carry the American flag. In 1998, Thai introduced Glory,
the Star Spangled Bear.
So collectors in different parts of the world were scrambling to get the beanies that were rare in their country, making them much more valuable.
And Ty did their part to help keep the cost up by limiting the number of beanies a person was allowed to bring into the country, to one per person.
People were actually stopped at the airport and had the Britannias and Maples taken away from them.
An important thing to note is that as crazy as the Beanie Baby craze has been in the United States, it's just starting in other countries. As people in England or Canada or Germany start searching for Doodle the Rooster, which was never sold in England, or some original Beanie Babies, their value will once again grow. Remember, supply and demand. A rule of thumb that many beanie collectors use is to buy three beanies. One to sell, one to trade, and one to add to your collection. Or to play with if you're not a collector.
Speaking of playing, we found a group of kids who created a playhouse just for beanies.
Hi, beanie fans! Beanies! Beanies!
I like Wrinkles. And because he has wrinkles, and I also like dressing him up in cute outfits.
I like Rainbow because he's really soft, and I love rainbows.
Well, Garcia I like because it's very expensive, and it's very like tie-dye, and I like the colors. And Freckles I like because it's she's cute, and I like the freckles on it. And Magic I like because I just like it because she's pretty.
I got four of them at the same time because I had my molar pulled, so that was my present. And I had, I think, Congo, Bones, Spot, and Snip. And Snip reminds me of my cat, Alfie. He's black and white, and Snip's black and white.
My sister had Hoppity, and then my aunt got me Flippity and Floppity, and now I have Hippity, Hoppity, and Floppity.
When McDonald's released Teeny Beanie Babies, it started a whole new craze and sold more Happy Meals in company history. How many Teeny Beanie Babies were given away by McDonald's? The answer? Over 340 million. That's more teenies than there are people in the United States. On April 11th, 1997, McDonald's introduced Teeny Beanie Babies. Teeny Beanie Babies are miniature versions of the regular Beanie Babies, which are miniature versions of Ty's larger plush toys, which are
Sam!
Sorry. McDonald's started with 10 teenies, and the promotion was scheduled to run for 5 weeks.
Would you like any
but
Beanie
fans bought 100 million teenies in less than a week, which set off widespread panic and sold lots of Happy Meals.
We would go to McDonald's, we'd take turns, and we'd buy the limit, which was five, and then we'd check each beanie. And I remember one day she was home, so I went all the way to Cleveland, bought five beanie or McDonald's Happy Meals, drove to Porter, where they still had them. I felt like the McDonald-mobile. I never have. Could stand the smell of
McDonald's for lunch. Look.
So I showed up at her place with 10 Happy Meals. I said, here, here's lunch. And I'm like, oh, just give me the beanies.
Causes a frenzy at the stores, and everybody and their mother wants to collect or get their full set of teeny beanies. They're never given away right. Okay, you go into one McDonald's, they're giving away number 1, 7, and 11 when they're supposed to give away 1, 2, and 3 the first week, 4, 5, and 6 the second week. That causes a problem too, because then you don't know which one you need, which one you don't have. When you go to the next store, they're giving away the next set. You don't have the first set. You have a sporadic set. People are paying anywhere up to $20 for the teeny beanies to complete their collections. The 1995 set is selling for approximately $150, whereas the new set is selling for anywhere to $180 to $220. It is more a collection when you have a miniaturized pinchers and then the full-size parent pinchers, same as Waddle. But now that Waddle is retired and Zip is retired and Pinchers is retired, it makes the collection that is currently hard to get worth a little bit more money because everybody is retired. In the first collection, there are still a couple like Chocolate the Moose, who's still not retired. And that's one of the reasons that the value today is higher than the value was on the older pieces. But you need to keep your beanie in the plastic. It has to be original. You also, to give it value, need to have the bag it came in originally. So there's a lot of things, again, that you need to do if you're collecting a teeny beanie set to make it have value.
Can you tell if your Beanie Baby is a real Beanie Baby? Believe it or not, fake Beanie Babies have been found in many different parts of the country, especially fakes of the more valuable Beanie Babies. So beware of what you buy and who you buy it from. Here are some tips on how to spot a fake Beanie Baby.
Well, you really have to know what you're buying, if anything. I mean, anytime you put a lot of money into something, you have to research it and know what you're going for. The Beanie Mom site is, again, a really good site to look at. They list how to tell counterfeit beanies apart and everything, but usually their noses are a lot bigger, and then the material, just by, I've felt enough of them, so just by the feel, you can feel it. It's a rougher, it's not as soft or as smooth, it just doesn't feel right. And then the beans are a different size, and a lot of times the eyes are a lot bigger. If something doesn't seem right and it's at a low price, it probably is a counterfeit.
So now you know everything there is to know about beanies, right? Well, here's a beanie quiz to test your knowledge. Go get a pencil and a piece of paper. It's okay, I'll wait. Okay, here we go. And if you get all the answers correct, then you're spending way too much time with your beanies. What was the first beanie dog sold? What was the second? Many beanies are made from the same fabric. Do you know what beanie shares its fabric with Bronte the dinosaur? What beanie was given away in memory of the Chicago Cubs announcer, Harry Carey? What valuable beanie was replaced by Dottie the Dalmatian? What was the first cat to be retired? What's so special about Humphrey the Camel's tail? What's the smallest member of the Beanie Baby family? What are the biggest changes from a second generation tush tag to a third generation tush tag? What common misspelling is on thousands of Beanie Baby tags? Well, that's it. We hope you had as much fun as we did. By the time you watch this tape, there will probably be 12 new Beanie Babies on the market and 24 newly retired ones.
That's what makes collecting beanies so much fun. There's always something new.
And the fact that they're so cute.
Careful with that peanut, you'll twist the tag.
No, I won't.
Look, it's creased already.
It is not.
Then
it's not creased.